Good morning. With Christmas just around the corner, I've been seeing a lot of Christmas lights going up all around my neighborhood. Such a pretty time of year. I love driving around at night and seeing all those lights sparkling through the darkness so brightly, and it reminds me of how we Christians are to shine the light of Jesus in this dark world. Now, last month, I taught about letting the light of Jesus shine through our life because this is the only way some people will ever see Jesus. Jesus needs our light to shine for him in this dark world, and that is a powerful thought. That is also a little bit scary of a thought, too. Scary to think that if the light of Jesus does not shine through me, and it does not shine through those who have him in their heart, then the light of Jesus cannot shine in this world. It is imperative then that we allow our light, the light of Jesus, to shine. Now, today, I want to talk about how there are some ways that a light bulb, even if the power is on, can be hindered from shining. Likewise, what I'm really talking about is that there are some ways that even though a Christian has the Holy Spirit inside, that he can be hindered from shining through their life. How can a light be hindered from shining? Well, first of all, is that the light bulb could be dirty. If you cover a light bulb in dirt, dust, or mud, it will not shine very brightly. That light inside will barely be able to shine through all that filth on the outside. Now, if you allow the filth of sin to reign in your body, Jesus's light within you will not be able to shine very brightly. If you are acting and living just like your unsaved coworkers or family members, do you think they are seeing the light of Jesus shining through you? Not at all. The Bible tells us that we are to clean up our life, live holy before God. 2 Corinthians 7, verse 1. Let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Philippians 2, 14 and 15. Do all things without murmurings and disputings, that ye may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God, without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom ye shine as lights in the world. The second way a light could be hindered from shining is if you covered it up. Now, I don't know what the purpose of that would be, but you could turn on a lamp and then, put a blanket over the top or a bucket or something and cover that light. Again, I don't know why you would do that, but you could do it. You could cover up that light. Jesus seems to ask that question here in Mark 4:21. Is a candle brought to be put under a bushel or under a bed and not to be set on a candlestick? In other words, Jesus is trying in those verses to get us to realize that there is no point of having a light if you are going to cover it up. You could try to hide Jesus living within you, but I don't understand why you would do that. I mean, isn't the whole purpose of having a light is to let it shine? Luke 11:33, no man, or we could say woman, no man, when he hath lighted a candle, putteth it in a secret place, neither under a bushel, but on a candlestick, that they which come in may see the light. The third way a light can be hindered from shining is if it gets unplugged. Do you have any lamps in your home? I have several. And what good are those lamps if they're not plugged in? Your house may have electricity, the power may be on, but your lamps will not shine if they are not plugged in. And likewise, a Christian may have the Holy Spirit or the power source living inside, but their light will not shine unless they are plugged into that power source. I feel this is probably one of the greatest reasons that Christians don't seem to be making much of an impact in this dark world today. I think we have not plugged into the power of the Holy Spirit to change lives. Without him, our good works that we do to try to shine the light of Jesus to the world, all those things that we do, they're pointless without the power of the Holy Spirit. They are as pointless as a lamp in your living room that is not plugged in. Get plugged into the power of the Holy Spirit. He alone can give you the strength to shine in this dark world. This dark world needs a light. It needs the light of Jesus, but Jesus is not here physically. He lives within us, and he needs our life to shine for him. in this dark world. If we don't shine for him, if we don't shine for him, this world will never know Jesus. Your life may be the only way some people ever see Jesus. Your neighbor may never come to church, but they should see Jesus shining through you. The grocery clerk that you see may never come to church, but they should see Jesus shining through the words you speak to those around you. And they should see him shining through the way you treat that lady that cut in front of you. How's your light shining? Is it bright, or is it covered in the filth of selfishness, the filth of pride, envy, jealousy, sin? Is it shining clearly to your neighbors, or do they see you living just like all the other neighbors around them? No difference at all. Luke 11:36, if thy whole body therefore be full of light, having no part dark, the whole shall be full of light, as when the bright shining of a candle doth give thee light. When you think about it, that's a pretty big job. We have a big task ahead of us. That job will be much more difficult if our light is dirty, or we unplug our light, or if we are trying to cover it up. Don't be ashamed of Jesus. Let his light shine through your life to the dark world around you. You have no idea who needs his light this December, this week. Maybe it's someone you work with, or maybe it's your neighbor or someone in your family. I don't know who it is, but I know that Jesus needs our light to shine forth his light. Without you, he can't shine. Don't let your light go out. Stay connected to the power source, the Holy Spirit, and let your light shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. How about you?